Hi everyone, this is Chris from Recombu, and I'm here with the Google Pixel phone, Google's new super premium Android flagship phone. And I'm going to do a quick comparison with Huawei P9, which is a very, very nice Android phone, came out earlier this year. It's Huawei's own flagship phone, just to see what the difference is. So, Google Pixel, it's a 5-incher compared to the 5.2-inch Huawei P9. There's not a massive amount of difference in terms of size, though, as you can see. The Google Pixel phone does have quite big bezels above and below the screen. They're more or less the same height. In terms of actual thickness and everything, the Google Pixel phone is a bit thicker, as you can see there. It's nice and slim, the P9, just 7 millimeters, so definitely gorgeously slender, if that's what you're into. In terms of the actual design and everything as well, as you can see, the P9 is a bit more rectangular. You've got these nice sort of rounded corners on the Pixel phone. If you flip around to the back, you'll see there's a clear difference. There's a nice glossy top at the rear here on the Google Pixel phone, whereas the rest of it is metallic. And the Huawei is pretty much all metal, apart from this little camera strip at the very top there, which is nice and glossy as well. Got a nice sort of funky feel to it, a look, and the aesthetics are very, 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 very unique and attractive. Definitely fine, especially with this dual lens camera. Stands out quite a bit, and ditto the Pixel phone, you know, with this sort of blend of glass and metal, stands out a bit from your bog standard boring phones that you generally see in the phone stores. They both have a fingerprint sensor, both mounted on the back, of course, and all you have to do to open the phone is just tap your print to the sensor. So I'll tap it now on the Pixel phone, there you go, see, nice and fast and accurate. And it's the same on the Huawei as well. I haven't actually set up my print on this one, so I cannot demonstrate right now. But take my word for it, it's super fast and accurate in both cases as well. You'll rarely see an error message of any kind. Both about the same weight as well, 143 compared to 144 grams. So got a nice bit of heft to it. They definitely feel really good in the hand, and they're sort of just about usable one-handed. You can just about stretch up to the notifications bar and the rest. So that's in terms of the design. In terms of the screens themselves, 5-inch full HD screen on the Pixel and a 5.2-inch Full HD screen on the Huawei P9. So in both cases, you get nice crisp visuals. They might not be full Quad HD, like a lot of flagships, like the HTC 10 and the S7 and stuff, for instance. But you know what? You're gonna really, really struggle to see any individual pixels there. Visuals are very, very good indeed. Just everything's just nice and sharp in both cases. Very good if you're like kicking back with a movie or a TV show on your commute. You can actually tweak the color temperature here on the Huawei P9 as well, so you can get it looking just the way you like. Or for instance, if it's late at night, just stick it on warm, and it makes the visuals just a little less piercing and less likely to disturb your partner if they're snoring away next to you. So that's a nice to have feature as well. In terms of the actual performance, you get Kirin 955 in the Huawei P9, which you might not have heard of unless you enjoy Huawei phones in general. It's surprisingly nippy, backed up by 4 gigs of RAM, so the latest apps and games play absolutely no problem whatsoever. And on Google's phone, you get the super spanking new Snapdragon 821, backed by, again, 4 gigs of RAM. And again, it's super nippy. I haven't seen a single stutter on this, even when we were setting it up. It's been super, super fast. Good old Android Nougat is running nicely with all of its cool new features, swipe up apps tray, the boosted notification stuff, which finally comes with a clear all, hooray, and all the rest of it. And the settings menu is now much nicer as well. You get full access to support if you want it. And no matter what menu you're in, you can quickly access any other settings, which is good. And you also get full exclusive access to Google's new Assistant AI, which is pretty good at picking up what you're saying and sort of trying to help out with whatever your life issue is, as you can see. So let's get rid of that before it does a really weird search. On the Huawei, you get Android 6.0, but Huawei's also overlaid its own launcher, which basically, unfortunately, removes the apps tray, but does add in a good bit of extra styling as well. Your notifications and your shortcuts are separated, as you can see. There are lots of extra settings in there. There's some good gesture support and the rest. So there's some good stuff there, but you don't get the assistant even when it gets the update to Nougat, when/if, but I'm sure it will do. And in terms of storage, you get 32 gigs built into the Huawei P9, but it's expandable via a micro SD memory card slot, which is in the little SIM tray right there. Pixel, you get a choice of either 32 or 128 gigabytes, which is nice. The 128 gig version will cost you an extra 100 quid, so you'll have to dig deep for that one. And unfortunately, if you want to carry around lots of media apps and the rest, you'll have to, because there's no micro SD support in the SIM tray, sadly. You do get free Google Photos backup at full resolution for your photos and videos, but that's not much use again if you want to carry around lots of high def movies and the rest. Bugger. Battery life, battery. You get 3000 milliamp battery in the Huawei P9, 2770 in the Google Pixel. We find we get a day and a half quite comfortably out of the P9, even with a sort of fair bit of use. And on the Google Pixel, we get about a day so far at the moment. We haven't done full tested, so we've only had it a couple of days. But yeah, about a day of life per charge, and they both support quick charge and everything, which is lovely. And in terms of the camera tech, now, this is where the P9 really, really shines. That's my face. Yes, I definitely need more coffee because I'm looking a little bleary-eyed there. But as we previously mentioned, you get a nice dual-lens camera on the back there. And this comes in particularly handy for the lovely bokeh effect. You just give this a tap. And then you can tap on Mr. Android. And basically just adds a nice sort of blurry effect to the background and just really helps the image to stand out. It works particularly well outdoors when you're shooting someone against a big backdrop. Very, very cool indeed. You can do a similar sort of thing with the Pixel phone. But of course it doesn't have the dual lenses, it's just got the one 12 megapixel lens. So two 12 megapixel lenses, one 12 megapixel lens. You've got the lens blur option, you have to sort of tap on someone and then hit that and then very slowly go up. And it adds again a sort of a blurry effect to the background. It sometimes works, it sometimes doesn't. But general everyday use, it is very, very good indeed. You can take, as you can see, focus is very, very fast, whether you're manually focusing or using the autofocus. You can fiddle with the brightness levels, and you've got the HDR plus mode, which helps out in high contrast situations. You can also quickly fiddle with like the color temperature and stuff. So there's some basic manual controls there, nothing too extreme. It is generally quite a simple snapper. You get a few bonus modes like the slow motion and the rest. And it's super fast at taking photos, as you can see. There's absolutely no delay whatsoever. And with the P9, again, super fast to focus, as you can see. You can again quickly fiddle with the brightness, but you also get this pull-out pro controls, which is quite handy. So you can have a quick fiddle with like some ISO level and all the rest of it as well to get your shot just the way you want it. And slip that away if you don't want to see it. And you've got the usual filters and all the rest as well, of course, if you so desire. So that in a nutshell is the Huawei P9 versus the Google Pixel. Hopefully giving you an idea of which one might be best for you. Let us know in the comments below which one you think you would buy and why, of course. They both cost more or less the same. Google Pixel is slightly more expensive at $599. The P9, I think you can pick up for around $450 to $500 now. And it's coming in a nice burgundy color as well, which is very nice indeed. We checked that out yesterday. So let us know what you think in the comments below and stay tuned for lots more Google Pixel content. Thanks for watching.